Or in this place, let's go check it out. Got a nice window up here to look through.
What's this window for?
I don't know. It's probably... There's those rafters up on the top. Maybe it's for, like, moving that a crane around or something. There's buttons there to do something.
Fine, it's logical. I was just wondering if they installed a window because it looked nice or something.
It might have been that. It might have been a secondary function because it looks nice.
Looks nice.
Just pop a squat here. Wait for a little bit. Wait for these yellow men to go by. Gets up really fast.
Be careful. You absolutely must not use weapons in that area.
I've already programmed the nanomachine so that he won't be able to, Colonel.
What? What are you talking about?
Have you forgotten? That's where they keep the nuclear warheads. Can't you see them?
Yeah, there's lots of boxes piled up here, but are they all warheads?
Yes, they're all dismantled warheads.
They just leave them here? It's like President Baker said. Totally careless.
They're working on a limited budget. They try to put on a pretty face for the media, but this is the grim reality of it. Nastasha knows lots more about it than I do.
All of the warheads in those boxes have had their detonation mechanisms removed, so there's no fear of them exploding. But if the warheads are broken, they might leak plutonium, and that would be a serious problem.
Snake, never use your weapon on that floor.
No, it's like that in MGS2, and I think it's like that in MGS1 also, where guns are ID'd to the nanomachines or whatever.
To make sure spies can't steal them. I don't know what other function that would have. It's my gun. Bill, don't take my gun.
Don't take it. I know you like my gun better than yours, but look.
Does it say
our
Bill
genes
on
are
it?
Different.
No. It says Steve on it. Steve's gun.
Does your gun have my genes on it? Nope.
Nope. See, that it was a problem until they did that.
Yeah. I mean, before, you just had to, like, write your name in, like, black marker with, like, Sharpie on the side of your gun and hope nobody takes it.
Put personalized stickers on it and stuff.
Yeah.
Sparkly Hello Kitty things.
It's ooh, like Trapper Keeper stickers.
With the bubble paint.
Man, bubble paint.
Bubble paint, oh my god.
Maybe the soldiers have, shit, what was that other thing everybody had in grade school, too? That
gel pens?
Yes, gel pens.
How did I know it was gel pens?
I don't know. Everybody went, like, bonkers for gel pens. Even I did. I drew, like, dragons and shit with them because I was retarded as hell.
You didn't draw dragons. Gel pens. And puff paint.
I never used that. What did that stuff do? I don't remember that stuff.
Puff paint? Bubble paint? I think it's the same thing.
Oh.
Thank
God. God, this elevator's taking forever. Come on. Poke the button like a millisecond before it arrives. Good timing.
Snake, put the elevator into service mode so nobody gets on between floors.
Yeah. We gotta go to the basement too so we can find the scientist man. Oh, and he's right there! Hell, Emmerich. Hey. Hey. Hey.
He's deaf in his left ear. Stop it.
Oh, dang it. Tapping like a madman on that wall.
The mad tapper.
Rap tapper.
Watch out! That place is filled with gas. Also, the floor is electrified. First, destroy the high voltage switch. It's the switchboard on the northwest wall.
But how? I can't reach it.
Use a remote-controlled missile.
Just believe, Snake, and your arms will stretch out all the way over. We programmed your nanomachines to be Mr. Fantastic in this one room, okay?
Yes.
We can do that.
Where do I get to be the girl? I mean invisible.
So we gotta look for a remote controlled missile launcher sounds like something most offices have. Some science labs, I'm sure they're there in a stockpiles. Whoa! Hello there. Oh,
there's a missile right there.
Look at that.
Crane your neck and look at that dog.
He's
pissing steam.
I know. I'm sorry, but you have to die.
I bet he peed all over you.
Probably did. Let's go. Oh yeah, in Twin Snakes, they put magazines in to distract people. And on the magazines, on the cover and inside, are characters from Silicon Knight's first game, which was Eternal Darkness for the GameCube. And then they made Too Human, which took forever to make, and it was bad. Womp womp. Oh, and you can put men in bathrooms. Here you go. Here you go, buddy. It's more comfortable. Oh yeah, let's dry your hands. I'm sure that man sprayed pee everywhere while we died, so...
That's so cute.
Yep.
I miss the old bathroom. It was a little more classier than that bathroom.
Yeah.
Twin Snakes' bathroom is better.
Yeah, it's got nice wood paneling everywhere.
More soothing, more feng shui place to take a piss.
Yeah. All these doors are locked, but I mean, this is like an office place for scientists, but I'm sure they keep missile launchers in here, right?
With only one guard guarding it.
Oh, hey, here's one, yeah. It's just right there in that scientist's little office place.
He got it for his kid, he didn't know what it was.
RC missile launcher, that sounds like a toy.
Oh, cool.
Cool. I mean, I was expecting to be made by, like, Tonka or something, but... Alright.
Johnny will love this.
Wow, that was a lot faster than I was expecting.
Wasn't it already on the floor?
Well, I don't know. Sometimes it, like, leaves. It goes back up. These elevators kind of dick sometimes. Just leave. And then you have to press the button and wait all over again. And I hate that.
Oh, it's like real life.
Oh, it's yellow. Smelly. So... steer our missile around, because that missiles can do that.
It also turns on a fucking dime.
Yeah.
Despite having no side propulsion. It's just one rocket.
Missile's getting a little drunk there. There's also gun cameras in there that can shoot your missile down, but they're really easy to avoid, so... Let's solve that.
Cutscene didn't know what to do with itself. Camera's going everywhere. Okay, let's go.
I just breathed in a whole bunch of toxic gas, but you know, whatever. I got oxygen, it's gone now. That didn't permanently damage my nervous system or anything.
I feel better, in fact. From this point on, his voice gets more gravelly and therefore better in the rest of the game. It's all because of this
gas.
This pee gas.
Yellow gas. Pea gas. It's not a thing.
How do you know?
Well, you see, I'm an expert. I don't know. I don't know. I can't think anything witty for that. But, oh. This is something on this door. It's not in Twin Snakes, it's just a normal door. But in the original, it says Hal's Lab. Keep out, not Hell's Lab.
Hell's Kitchen.
It's the gang scientists made. It's where they all hang out. Hell's Lab.
They wouldn't let us meet in the library, so our club meets here.
There's always one that always tells the guy that his mom's pretty hot whenever she comes down to give him snacks.
Shut up, man. It's gross.
Like they were cut by some type of blade.
I see why you're one of the best spies America has to offer.
I'm a good detective. I'm a detective, right?
Are there a bunch of ghosts eating a lot in this room?
Maybe. But actually the chanting are all names of like railways in Japan.
Mm-hmm.
Does that still exist? I haven't seen blueberry ever.
I'm pretty sure it does.
Well, it looks like tomorrow I'm going to go out and buy some blueberries, some gel pens.
This is the nostalgia episode of Metal Gear Solid 1.
The guy's still kind of alive, and if you crouch like right there, you get a special camera angle.
Huh.
It does that for like any time there's like a guy on the ground, like dead or like dying.
Or Johnny.
You can just like crouch near them and you get a bunch of different camera angles. It's kind of weird that they put all those in, but whatever.
Stealth camouflage? Who are you?
Where is my friend?
What? What are you talking about? Next,
Snake.
You're that ninja.
I've been waiting for you, Snake.
Who are you?
Neither enemy nor friend. I am back from a world where such words are meaningless. I've removed all obstacles. Now you and I will battle to the death.
What do you want?
I've waited a long time for this day. Now I want to enjoy the moment.
What's with these guys? It's like one of my Japanese animes.
I've come from another world to do battle with you.
What is it, revenge?
It is nothing so trivial as revenge. A fight to the death with you. Only in that can my soul find respite. I will kill you, or you will kill me. It makes no difference.
No!
Ah, fine. He can watch from inside there.
I need that man. Keep your hands off him.
Now, make me feel it. Make me feel alive again.
Okay, have a bunch of bullets. Oh.
Do you feel better?
Well, okay. I'll just get over here. I'll punch ya.
Have a knuckle sandwich. Maybe that'll make you feel better.
Yep. Except it barely does any damage.
Good. Now we can fight as warriors. Hand to hand. It is the basis of all combat. Only a fool trusts his life to a weapon.
Okay, come here, you silly ninja. Run into my fists like a million times, please.
You silly bitch.
So literally the only way you can hurt him in this boss fight is by punching and kicking. And you have to punch and kick him a lot because it does not do much damage. Yeah, and you can't... If you try to flip him over your shoulder, he just lands on his feet. And you can't actually grab him and try to, like, choke him out. You just can't do it at all.
He's a nimble motherfucker.
He's really nimble, because he's a ninja, you see.
And he's also a cyborg, so...
Yeah.
He's even better than the average ninja, so...
Yeah, and if he's a cyborg, I mean, I don't think you're really going to be able to snap his neck very easily.
It's a robot neck.
In Twin Snakes, the music is awesome, at least. And even though I don't show it, there's a way to do more damage to him. And that's because in Twin Snakes you can melee with most guns. And we have the Nikita launcher with us. And that's a really slow melee with that, but if you hit him with it, it does like four times as much damage as a punch. So if you hit him with it, you can make the fight go by a lot faster. I wish you could do that in the original. Because the fight's honestly kind of really long.
But the music is so good.
Yeah, the music's pretty cool at least. I like all the new boss music in Twin Snakes. It's pretty good.
That's good, Snake. Hurry up and catch me.
Well, you're right there. I wasn't... You didn't do a very good job there at all.
Camera, you dick. Why did you show me off?
I'm here, Snake.
Okay. Well, you're right here. Hello.
Hi. Thanks for telling.
Unfortunately, this time I couldn't figure out where he was because my speakers weren't up that loud, so I couldn't tell. I couldn't really tell if he teleported to the left or to the right.
Hurry up and catch me.
So, unfortunately, I'll just punch that computer. Instead.
You just ruined 20 years of work.
Well, I'm sorry. They should have kept backups. Should have been more responsible scientists. Should have invested in giant server hard drive things that don't explode with a single punch.
I've been waiting for this pain.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I mean, if you want more, you could just stand here and I could beat you up all day. I mean,
meet you at the flagpole at 3.
Okay. Well, I want to hurt you more, but I literally cannot hurt you. You're crouching. Snake can't punch down, and he can't punch while crouching, so I just have to wait for you to get up.
That's it. I remember that punch.
Okay. Get up. Get a little bit more. Come on.
Do you remember, Snake? The feel of battle. The clashing of bone and sinew.
Yep.
That's good, Snake.
No.
Oh, it's bad. These are bad feelings I'm giving you. You should ask for, like, hugs.
Hug me more!
Pat on the back.
That's good, Snake.
A few little tender kisses, maybe.
Cuddle me more!
I remember that kiss, Snake.
I remember that hug.
That was awesome. Oh.
I know. How'd that hurt me from way over there? This part isn't in Twin Snakes, and I played Twin Snakes first, and so when I did this fight the first time in the original MGS1, it killed me, because I thought the fight was going to end and not do this. And getting hit by the bubble kind of does a lot of damage.
Oh, he's making the papers fly up.
Oh, yeah. Huh. Look, that chair's bouncing up and down. Boing. Boing.
Are you wimping out?
I'm psyching myself out with that bubble. It's scary.
Zanzibar. What? Not again. What's happening?
Gray Fox! Colonel, that ninja is Gray Fox. No doubt about it.
Ridiculous. You of all people should know he died in Zanzibar.
No. He should have died, but he didn't.
What?
It happened before I joined Foxhound's medical staff. They were using a soldier for their gene therapy experiments.
I never heard that.
It happened right after you retired. My predecessor, Dr. Clark, was in charge.
Dr. Clark?
Yes. He started the gene therapy project.
And where is he now?
He was killed in an explosion in his lab 2 years ago.
So what about this soldier?
Apparently, for their test subject, they decided to use the body of a soldier who was recovered after the fall of Zanzibar.
And that was Gray Fox.
But he was already dead.
Yes. But they revived him. They fitted him with a prototype exoskeleton and kept him drugged for 4 years while they experimented on him like a plaything. Today's genome soldiers were born from those experiments.
That's the sickest thing I ever heard.
They used him to test all sorts of gene therapy techniques.
Naomi, why didn't you tell us about this sooner?
Because it's confidential information.
Is that the only reason?
Naomi, what happened to Gray Fox after that?
The record says he died in the explosion.
I see. But even if that ninja is Gray Fox, the question is, why?
From what I could tell, he didn't know who he was.
Are you saying that he's just a mindless robot?
I'm not sure, but he seems intent on fighting me to the death. We'll meet again. I know it.
So you'll fight again? Until you kill him?
Huh. I'd rather not. But maybe that's what he wants.
How long are you gonna stay in there?
Huh? Are you one of them?
No, I'm not. I always work alone.
Alone? Are you an otaku too?
Come on, get out. We can't stay here forever.
Your uniform is different than theirs.
You're the Metal Gear Chief Engineer, Hal Emmerich, right?
You know me?
I heard about you from Meryl.
Oh, so you're here to rescue me?
Sorry, but no. There's something that I've got to do first.
Oh. Well, at least you're not one of them.
Huh. Are you hurt?
I'm okay. I just twisted my ankle a little bit trying to get away.
Well, if that's all, it's nothing to worry about. I want to ask you something. I need information about Metal Gear.
Huh? Metal Gear?
Yeah. What's Metal Gear really designed for?
It's a mobile TMD. It's designed to shoot down nuclear missiles. Only for defensive purposes, of course.
Fire! I already know that Metal Gear is nothing but a nuclear-equipped walking deathmobile.
Nuclear? What are you talking about?
The terrorists are planning to use Metal Gear to launch a nuclear missile. You telling me you didn't know?
They're gonna put a dismantled warhead into Metal Gear's TMD missile module?
Wrong. From the beginning, the purpose of this exercise was to test Metal Gear's nuclear launch capability using a dummy nuclear warhead. The terrorists are just continuing the work you started.
No, you're wrong.
I heard it directly from your boss, Baker.
No. A nuclear missile on Rex?
So you really didn't know?
No. All the armament was built by a separate department, and the president personally supervised the final assembly of the main unit.
President Baker?
Yeah. I was never told exactly what they armed Rex with. I only know it's equipped with a Vulcan cannon, a laser, and a railgun.
A railgun, you said?
Yeah. It uses magnets to fire bullets at extremely high velocities. The technology was originally developed for the SDI system and later scrapped. We were successful in miniaturizing it in a joint venture between ArmsTech and Rivermore National Labs. The railgun is on Rex's right arm.
Metal Gear's main function is to launch nuclear missiles. You sure you're not forgetting something?
It's true that Metal Gear has a missile module on his back that can carry up to 8 missiles, but are you saying it was originally meant to carry nuclear missiles?
Yeah, but that's not all, I think. If Metal Gear fired only standard nuclear missiles, then they should already have all the practical data they need.
No. Could it be? Metal Gear's co-developer, Rivermore National Labs, was working on a new type of nuclear weapon. They were using Nova and NIF laser nuclear fusion testing equipment and supercomputers.
So they developed a new type of nuclear weapon in a VR testing lab, huh?
Yes, but you can't use virtual data on a battlefield. They would need actual launch data. These are some of the supercomputers. If you link these, you can test everything in a virtual environment. But it's all just theoretical.
So this exercise was designed to test the real thing.
What did our president do? If the terrorists launched that thing... Damn! I'm such a fool! It's all my fault! The truth is, my grandfather was part of the Manhattan Project. He suffered with the guilt for the rest of his life. And my father, he was born on August 6th, 1945.
The day of the Hiroshima bomb. God's got a sense of humor, all right.
Three generations of Emmerich men. We must have the curse of nuclear weapons written into our DNA. I used to think that I could use science to help mankind. But the one that wound up getting used was me. Using science to help mankind, it's just in the movies.
That's enough crying. Pull yourself together. Where is Metal Gear? Where on this base are they keeping it?
Rex is in the underground maintenance base.
Where's that?
North of the communications tower, but it's a long way there.
The emergency override system for the detonation code is there too?
Yeah, in the maintenance base control room. You'd better hurry. If they were planning a launch from the start, then their ballistic program is probably finished. And since they haven't called for me in a few hours, they must not need me. In other words, they must be ready to launch.
Meryl's got the detonation code override keys. We'll link up with her.
If we can't override the launch, we'll have to destroy Rex. I'll show you the way.
On that leg of yours, you'll just slow me down.
You'll need me if you're gonna destroy Rex.
I don't need you. I just need your brain.
I created Rex. It's my right, my duty to destroy him.
If you get a chance, try to escape. When the coast is clear, I'll contact you by codec.
How am I supposed to escape from an island?
Okay.
So what then?
I want you to hide somewhere and keep me informed. You know this place well, don't you?
Of course I do. And don't worry, I've got this. It's the same stealth technology as the Ninja. Foxhound was gonna use them, but with this I'll be fine. Bad leg and all.
Good. But I want Meryl to watch after you too. Meryl, the engineer's okay.
That's a relief.
I want you to look after him. Where are you now?
Very close.
There she is! Over there!
Oh no! Damn, they've spotted me!
Meryl, what happened? Something's wrong.
Did you hear something? Wasn't that some kind of music?
What did she look like?
She was wearing the same green uniform as the terrorists.
A disguise?
She had such a cute way of walking. She kind of wiggles her behind.
You were really looking.
Well, she's got a very cute behind.
Way of walking, huh?
If she's disguised as the enemy, you'll have to contact her when she's alone, huh? There's only one place where we can be sure she's by herself.
Where's that?
Don't be so dense. Here, use this security card. It's security level 4.
You're not in pain, are you?
Huh?
You feel okay? Nothing bothering you?
What's wrong? You're getting all friendly all of a sudden.
No, nothing. Just glad you're okay.
You're strange.
I'm a little nervous. Everyone else I've saved suddenly dies.
You're bad luck.
Forget it, Doctor.
Call me Otacon.
Otacon?
It stands for Otaku Convention. An otaku's a guy like me who likes Japanimation. Japan was the first country to successfully make bipedal robots. They're still the best in the field of robotics.
And Japanese cartoons played some part in that?
They did. I didn't get into science to make nuclear weapons, you know.
That's what all scientists say.
I became a scientist because I wanted to make robots like the ones in the Japanese animes. Really, it's true.
Just sounds like a childish excuse to me.
You're right. We have to take responsibility. Science has always thrived on war. Greatest weapons of mass destruction were created by scientists who wanted to be famous. But that's all over now. I won't take part in murder anymore.
Whatever. All I want from you is information.
Sure. I know everything about this whole base. Ask me anything about Rex or about this place. Also, with this stealth camouflage, I can sneak in and out of the armory and mess hall. If you need ammo or rations, just tell me and I'll bring them to you. I'm on frequency 141.12. See you later.
I'll just sound like this.
Oh, God.
Hello, I'm Snake.
I like that Snake impression. That's good. So in Twin Snakes, it's only the Enders. In the original, it's all police nuts. Just like the cutscenes. And then over here, on this table, is a PlayStation 1.
Aww, and in Twin Snakes.
Twin Snakes,
it's a GameCube
with the Wave Bird, and it's also on the TV. Isn't that adorable? There's also, these guys.
Oh.
The hell are you doing here? Get out of this video game.
Oop. It's a them.
It's a them. They make noises.
Oh! I didn't know that!
And if you shoot Mario, it also heals you when you shoot Mario.
I didn't know that! That's adorable! I'm beside myself! Oh man! Yoshi!
Well, let's save.
Snake, there's an old Chinese saying, a scholar who cherishes the love of comfort is not fit to be deemed a scholar. Einstein said it another way. He said that only a life lived for others is worth living. That's why I entered MIT instead of Princeton or Vassar like my friends. I wanted to do applied physics, not just theoretical stuff. I wanted to make things for people. The Soliton radar system or the Kodak system. I just wanted to make something that would be useful for people. I think that it was the same for Dr. Emmerich, too. But he was used like a tool, used to make a horrible killing machine. Maybe it would be better if engineers like us just stopped making things. I don't know.
What a bummer.
That's great. Can I save?
Thanks for ruining the mood, you weirdo.